Ladies and gentlemen, the city of Kinston would like to give you a heartfelt welcome to the historic Grainger Stadium of the United States Air Force, the 13th Freedom Classic, and the 12th between the United States Air Force Academy and the United States Naval Academy. If you would like to be part of the on-field ceremony with the American flag, please report down to the third base today. Right now, we need adults and children. Adults and children, if you can help take the American flag field, for you children to be underneath the flag above the wing. What a great opportunity to be a part of this great ceremony here today. And that's fun. And we're going to introduce our club of today's game for leading off. The head coach for the Chargers is assisted by Jeff Payne, Adam Hackett, and Adam Ryan. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Navy. Now let's get the starting lineup for the Air Force Academy. And off the shortstop, 20 Eric Joe. Batting second, first baseman, number 5, Sam Alessandro. Batting third baseman, number 1, Jay Thomas. Batting fourth, left fielder, number 22, Chris Stallings. Fifth, right fielder, number 25, Jake Green. Batting sixth, center fielder, number 3, Chase Spencer. Batting seventh, the catcher, number 24, Walker Zapp. Batting eighth, designated fielder, number 12, Christian Taylor. And batting ninth, the second baseman, number 6, Connor Christensen. Pitching today for the Falcons, Grainger, number 18, Ben Weber. Air Force Academy is coached by Mike Keselowski, who is assisted by Drew McCone, Kyle Winkler, and Tyler Dawson. Ladies and gentlemen, the United States Air Force Academy. We'd like to direct your attention to the pitcher's mound, where Classic committee member, the late Eric Cantu. Let's see what you got, Gabriel. Fans, our colors are being piped onto and off the field by retired Army Sergeant First Class Robert White, the official bagpiper of the Special Forces Association. Fans, please rise as we welcome our Center Millennial Color Guard. Our nation's colors are being presented by the Kinston High School Junior ROTC Color Guard. The instructor is Lieutenant Colonel Beeson. The color guard is Cadet Zariah Brayson, Cadet Serenity Hamilton, Cadet Kiamonte Hargett, and Cadet Jonathan Schultes. The big flag is being brought onto the field by representatives of the Boy Scouts of America and RAND, raising awareness for the developmentally disabled. Please remain standing. Today's national anthem will be performed by Roger Fleming. Proud U.S. Air Force Academy. graduate and former F-15 pilot, Nasty remains one of our most skilled flight leads. And leading our ground coordinators is Scott Tadlock, a Bandit team member with 25 years of military aircraft maintenance experience. Ladies and gentlemen, how about a big round of applause for the Bandit flight team?
Welcome to Game 3 of the Freedom Classic between the Naval Academy and Air Force Academy. We have a beautiful day for baseball here in Kinston, North Carolina at historic Grainger Stadium. As I said, this is Game 3. The first two games were taken by the Falcons 7-1 on Friday evening and 10-0 yesterday in seven innings. We're looking forward to a great game here. We have beautiful weather, a little chilly here in Kinston. Highs in the low 50s. Wind looks not to be a factor today like it was yesterday. Very windy. Had a beautiful ceremony. Bagpipes piping in the flags for the color guard. Had a nice flyover. But we're looking, like I said, looking forward to a great time here tonight. Today, the Mids will be the away team, and they will be batting first. Falcons are taking the field now. This is a even series. This will be the 64th or 65th meeting between the Air Force Academy and the Naval Academy. And after last night, the series is tied at 32-32. Nobody, neither the Air Force nor the Navy, has swept the series, so the Mids will be looking to keep that alive today as they try to win the third game here. Tonight, this afternoon, pitching for the Mids will be Matthew Shira. And after posting a breakout junior season in 2023, the right-hander enters the 24th season as the Mids team captain. A native of Blue Ridge, Georgia, Shira earned himself all Patriot League second team honors in his second season as part of the weekend rotation in 2023. His team leading 58 strikeouts ranked fourth in the league compared to just 19 walks, while his .242 batting average against was fifth in the Patriot League, and his .383 ERA put the righty seventh in the league. On the mound for the Falcons is number 18 right-handed pitcher Ben Weber. Ben Weber has a 0-1 record so far this year in one appearance and one game started. He has a 7.71 ERA, and he's pitched 4.2 innings, allowing 7 hits and 4 earned runs. It looks like we're ready for action here in Game 3 as Zane Raba will lead it off for the Mids. First pitch, swinging strike to the center fielder. Second pitch is going to be outside, 1-1 count. Raba's leading the Mids with 9 hits this season so far. And that's going to be a foul tip, 1-2 count. His 9 hits, he has 4 doubles and 1 home run and 4 RBIs so far this year to lead the Mids batting. And check swing, but called strike. So Raba goes down on 4 pitches, and that's going to bring up the shortstop, number 10, Eduardo Diaz. Diaz has played in all 6 games so far for head coach Restano's team. First pitch he sees is inside, 1-0 count. Second pitch is a called strike, 1-1 count. And it's hit down to Tomlinson. He throws over, and he gets away from Coolisingham for the Falcons. See how they score that one. That's going to be an error on the Falcon first baseman. And now the senior third baseman for the Mids, Logan Keller, will step to the plate. Keller has 8 hits so far with 1 home run this season. First pitch he sees, foul down the third base side. The last two games, the mids have gotten behind early in the first, second, third innings of each game. So, you know, I know Coach Rossano, his team's looking to jump out ahead on the Falcons here in the top of the first. 0-1 count. Throw back over. Coolisingham fields that one cleanly. Still an 0-1 count. Called strike. 1-1 count, one out here in the top of the first. Throw back over, not in time. Diaz has shown this weekend that he's got some speed out on the bases, and I'm sure the mids are going to be playing very aggressive here in this final game of the series. Throw over again. Looks like they changed one of the balls back to a strike, so it's 0-2 count now. Scoreboard is updated. And Keller fights that one off into the mids dugout. Going to be called a ball on the outside. The Falcons thought that they had got that pitch right where they wanted, but home plate umpire disagreed. 1-2 count, one out to Logan Keller. Ball outside. Weber for the Falcons sets a 2-2 count. Swing and a miss. And that will retire Keller here in the top of the first.
Next up for the middies, second baseman number 4, Brock Murtha.
Brock Murtha, the next batter, the second baseman. First pitch he sees is a strike. O-1 count to Murtha. He's played in all six games so far. Started all six games this season. Next pitch he sees, a breaking ball down in the dirt. 1-1 count. Murtha has 5 hits so far this season, a double and a triple, and 5 RBIs, and he hits a ball down to third base side, foul ball. One, two count to Murtha. Hit out in the left field and going to get down, looking for extra bases. Here's the throw to third, and that's going to end the inning. Diaz thrown out at third. Good throw in from Tomlinson, the left fielder for the Falcons, and that's going to end the inning, trying to stretch it out. So after the top of the first, zero hits. Zero runs and one error for the Falcons. Baseball season is back at last. Join us for our next home game on Tuesday, February 27th, as the Mids take on Maryland Eastern Shore at 3 p.m. All Navy baseball games at Max Bishop Stadium are free attend. Again, that is 3 p.m. on Tuesday, February 27th, against Maryland Eastern Shore. Bottom of the first inning here, Eric Joe, the shortstop for the Falcons, leads it off. Matthew Shira, the pitcher for the Mids. First pitch, called strike. Pitching has been an issue for the Mids here the first two games of the series. Like I said earlier, they fell behind early in both games. Second pitch, a little high, 1-1 count. Foul ball back into the netting. Shira, the midshipman ace, did not pitch Friday, but is pitching here today. 1-2 count. Ball down. McCommon's doing a good job that back behind the plate to keep that in front of him. Done a good job of that all weekend, especially with runners on base. 2-2 count. Hit out into right. Manning's there. And after one batter, one out for the Mids.
Sam Coolisingham
now, the first baseman for the Falcons, the lefty up to bat. First pitch to Coolisingham is a strike on the outside of the plate. This is a very good matchup, a very good, arguably the best pitcher for the Mids against one of the best hitters for the Falcons. Second pitch, inside, called strike. Shira's got a head in, he's ahead in the count, 0-2 to Coolisingham. Hit to the shortstop, Diaz makes it, throws it over to Espirito, and now there are two outs here in the top of the first. Bottom of the first. That's going to bring up the third baseman, Jay Thomason, for the Falcons.
Now batting for Air Force, third baseman, number one, Jay Thomason.
Here's the pitch. Ball outside. 1-0 count. Ball outside. Shira behind in the count 2-0 to this batter. Called strike on the outside of the plate. Two, one count. Fouled back behind the Falcons dugout. Two, two count with two outs here in the bottom of the first. Shira looking to end the inning. And Thomason just gets a piece of that one, fouled back into the netting behind home plate. Still going to be a 2-2 count. Mids looking to do something they haven't done a lot this weekend, and that's go 1-2-3 in a half inning. Ball outside. Thomason's working it back to a full count here with two outs in the bottom of the first. Popped up. Diaz making his way back. Fury's coming in. And he makes the catch. So we have a 1-2-3 inning for in the bottom of the first for the Mids. We are heading to the top of the second. 0-0. Top of the second inning here. Right fielder Andrew Manning up to bat for the Mids. First pitch he sees, swinging strike. That's going to be a ball outside. Manning evens the count back up to 2-2. Pitch catches the piece. Strikeout looking for Andrew Manning. That's going to bring up the first baseman, Victor Izquierdo. He recorded the only hit in yesterday's game for the Mids. First pitch he sees, swings, and misses. O-1 count. Caught a ball, gets past the Falcons catcher. 1-1 count. Ball down 2-1 to Izquierdo. Takes that inside. 3-1 count. Izquierdo ahead in the count. Looking for a pitch to drive out into the outfield and hits that one back into the netting. Wasn't able to square that one up and drive it out into the field. So Izquierdo has a full count here, 3-2. And that hits him. He looks fine as he hustles down to first base. So with one out here in the top of the second, Brian Fury, the left fielder, coming up to bat. Mids have a man on first after the hit by pitch. First pitch, Fury sees, he swings and misses. O-1 count. Ball outside. Throw back over to first. Not in time. One count to Fury. Popped up into foul territory. A couple Falcons trying to make the play, and they will not get there in time as the ball bounces over into the stands. Souvenir for a young kid down there. They were hustling just as much as the three Falcons players over on the left field, left side of the field were for that ball. One, two count. Down. Zap, the Falcons catcher, gets in front of that ball to keep Izquierdo at first. 2-2 count to Fury. Two balls, two strikes. Checks his swing, and that's going to be a 3-2 count to the mids left fielder. See if Izquierdo is on the move here with a full count. Foul ball down the first base side. Two count, one out here in the top of the second. Driven out to left field, and that's going to be a foul ball. That was a foot or so away from getting down, and that would have been big for the mids here in the top of the second inning. But we're going to reset and go back. Fury protecting the plate here in the top of the second with one out. 3-2 count. Fouls back behind the home plate. Ball boy is busy today delivering fresh baseballs back to home plate umpire. 3-2 count, one out. Fouled off again. Back into the parking lot. And again, a full count here. And again, another foul ball. Fury's done a good job in this at bat, really protecting the plate and living to see another pitch. Three, two. And the patience paid off as that ball was down and inside, and now the mids have a man on first and second as Fury draws the walk. So after Manning going down, the first batter in this, the top of the second inning, a hit by pitch and a walk with one out. Now have the mids at first and second. And the catcher, Matt McCommons, first pitch he sees, swings and a miss. McCommons has started in all six games for the mids this year, has recorded three hits and two RBIs. Ball is down. 1-1 count to the mids catcher. Ball outside. Zapp looked like he wanted to throw down to first, but pulls it back and just delivers it back out to Weber, the Falcons pitcher. Here's the 2-1. Inside. And McCommons is ahead in the count. 3-1. Still one out here in the top of the second inning. Mids have runners on first and second. Catches a piece of the inside corner there. So McCommons at bat, 3-2 count, one out, runners on first and second. Hits it down to the shortstop, looking to turn two. There's the one and two, and the Falcons are going to get out of the inning after a hit by pitch and a walk. Fury. McCommons hits into the inning double play. We're heading to the bottom of the second. Baseball youth camps are back. Head coach Chuck Rostano and his staff will be offering summer camps this year at Max Bishop Stadium in Annapolis. Day camps will run July 8th through 11th and July 29th through August 1st, while overnight camps will be July 21st through the 23rd. And summer showcases will be conducted on June 19th and August 3rd. Just visit NavySports.com and click on the camps table for more information and registration details. Back here in the bottom of the second, Chris Stallings, the leadoff batter for the Falcons. First pitch he sees called strike. Matthew Shira's pitched a 1-2-3 inning in the first inning. 0-1 count. Breaking ball. Catches the plate. And Shira's ahead in the count, 0-2. Here's the 0-2. Down in the dirt, McCommons blocks that one. One, two count. Hit out into the gap. Manning trying to get over, makes the dive, but not in time. Can't field it cleanly. And Raba backing Manning up, gets the ball back into the infield. So that's going to be a leadoff single for Stallings. The right fielder, Jake Grieving, now up for the Falcons. Fouled straight back into the netting. That hit for Stallings is now his 10th on this very young season, which is leads the Falcons. Shira's checking back over to first. 0-1 count. Stallings takes off, swing and a miss, throw down to second. Not going to be in time. O-2 count to Grieving. Stallings, the previous batter on second after a single and a stolen base. Down in the dirt, McCommons blocks it, keeps Stallings at second. One, two count. Be a little bit high and outside. It's going to lead us to a 2-2 count. Driven out to left field. Fury there makes the catch, throws it in to his cutoff man Diaz, and that's going to keep Stallings at second base. And there's one out here in the bottom of the second. Center fielder Chase Spencer now up to bat for the Falcons. That's going to get away from the Commons, and Stallings is going to get down to third after that pitch in the dirt. So with one out here in the bottom of the second, 1-0 count, and a Falcon on third base. Next pitch is a ball. Keller, the mids third baseman, playing in on the grass for this bat, and now backs up to normal positioning. And that's hit in the gap in between first and second. Manning fields the ball and gets it in, but for Spencer, that was what the Falcons were looking for, as that scores the first run of the game. So Walker Zapp, the catcher, now up to bat. One out, mids trailing 1-0. Pitch over to first, keeping him honest. First pitch to Zapp. It's going to be high. 1-0 count. One out. And that catches Zapp on the shoulder. Looks like that pitch from Shira got away from him. That's going to bring up the designated hitter, Christian Taylor, making the start for the Falcons. Runners on first and second after a single and a hit by pitch. And that's inside. Rushes Taylor back a little bit. One-oh count to Taylor. Shira gets a ball past the swinging Taylor for a 1-1 count. Still one out here in the bottom of the second. Falcons scored on a single this inning. Swing and a miss. And Shira's ahead in the count, 1-2. Here's the 1-2. Runner takes off. Throw down to third. Not in time. And Spencer, the center fielder, is down at third, while Zapp, the catcher, is still at first. That pitch was a ball, so Taylor now has a 2-2 count. Runners on first and third. Foul straight back into the netting. Two count still. Hit to the shortstop. Diaz, second, first. And the mids turn a double play to only allow one Falcon run here in the bottom of the second. So after two, Air Force Academy 1, Naval Academy 0. We're heading to the top of the third. Back in the top of the third, the nine-hole hitter, designated hitter, Jack Finnegan, now up for the mids. First pitch catches a piece of the outside, 0-1 count. Finnegan looking for his first hit on the season. takes a cut, fouls that one back into the netting. Makes his way back onto the field. It's Ben Weber, the Falcons pitcher, tosses that one back into the dugout. 0-2 count to Finnegan. Ball inside. One, two. Weber gets him swinging. Brings us back to the top of the lineup. Center fielder Zane Raba will make his second plate appearance. Mids chasing an early run here, down 1-0. First pitch to Raba, called strike on the outside of the plate. 0-1 count. Nets dribbled into front of the catcher. And what's the call? Kula Singham made a great play for the Falcons over at first. Now they will get the second out here in the top of the third. Eduardo Diaz, the mid starting shortstop, reached on an error in the first inning. First pitch he sees, called strike. Diaz reached on an error in the first inning, was thrown out to end the inning at third base, trying to stretch it out. And quickly after two pitches, Diaz is behind in the count, 0-2 with two outs. Falcons wanted that call, but we're not going to get it from home plate umpire, as Diaz faces a 1-2 count here in the top of the third. Ball down in the dirt. 2-2 count. That's hit back up the middle. Joe, the shortstop, grabs it, tosses it over to Kula Singham, and that is going to end the top of the third inning. We're heading to the bottom of the third here at the Freedom Classic. Back here in the bottom of the third. Kids looking for a great way to celebrate your birthday? Have your party at a Navy sporting event with the Bill's Birthday Party Package. Your special day can include a pregame party featuring treats from Chick-fil-A, Fisher's Popcorn, and Nothing Bundt Cakes, as well as game tickets, a video board recognition, and more. For more information, call 1-800-US-4-NAVY. Connor Christensen leading off for the Falcons here in the bottom of the third. First pitch he sees, called strike. This is Christensen's first plate appearance this afternoon. Shows bunt. Bunts it down. Shira makes the play. Not going to be in time as it gets past Izquierdo. Throw down to second. And not in time. Joe, the leadoff hitter for the Falcons, now up to bat. His first plate appearance, he lined out to right fielder. Mr. Manning in the first inning. Shows bunt and misses. For the strike, Falcons have played a little bit of small ball all weekend. Bunting sacrifice bunts over, trying to get runners into scoring position. And already have one here after one batter in the bottom of the third. 0-1 count. Fouled back into the netting. He has a shortstop communicating with the infield. Shira has an 0-2 count. And McCommons blocks that, keeps that in front of him. So that ball's down in the dirt. One, two count. To the Falcon leadoff hitter. That one down in the dirt again, and McCommons does a good job keeping that one in front of him. Two count. Foul. Back down the first base side. Shira has a 2-2 count. Upstairs, going to be called a ball. Joe looked like he wanted to swing at that one, but held back. 3-2 count, no outs here in the bottom of the third. Falcon runner on second. That's hit down to the third baseman. Keller makes the play over to first. And gets the first out here in the bottom of the third. Sam Coolisingham now, the first Falcon first baseman, now up to bat. First inning, he hit it to Diaz at shortstop, made the throw over to Izquierdo for the out. First pitch he sees, hits it to Izquierdo. Shira covering and makes the play. That will advance Christensen down to third. But the Mids have two outs here in the bottom of the third with the Falcons runner over on third base. Shira and the Mids looking to get out of this inning, still trailing one. First inning, Tomlinson, the batter, flew out to the center fielder and hit first pitch he sees, swing and a miss. O-1 count. Hit down the first base side. That was called a foul ball. Izquierdo made the play on it. Would have had the easy touch on first to end the inning, but first base umpire said it crossed over into foul territory. So that brings us back. Shira has a 0-2 count on Thomason here in the bottom of the third. Two outs, one Falcon runner on third base. That's down in the dirt. Commons blocks that, keeps it in front of him. One thing that the mids do not want is a pass ball here to allow an easy run. That pitch outside, 2-2 count. Two outs here, bottom of the third. Foul, back into the netting. Thomason gets a piece of that and fouls that off down the third base side. Shira looking, trying to get out of a jam here with one Falcon on third base. Two outs in the bottom of the third. Here's the 2-2. Swing and a miss. And the mids are able to get out of a early jam. We're heading to the top of the fourth. Mids down 1-0 to the Falcons. Third baseman Logan Keller here to lead off the top of the fourth for the midshipmen. Keller struck out in the first inning. We wait for the committee who was just honored here in between the third and fourth inning to get off the field. Looks like we're ready for play now. And the first pitch that Keller sees inside. Keller dodged out of the way for that one. 1-0 count. Be down in the dirt. Keller's ahead early. 2-0. swing and fouled off. It was like Keller's right foot and hobbles a left foot, hobbles over to the grass, takes a little bit of time. 2-1 count to the senior third baseman. And that pitch is going to be down for a ball. So Keller ahead in the count as a 3-1 count, looking to try to get the ball in play. And he does and hits it to the shortstop. And Joe's not able to make the play. So Keller takes a wide turn around first, heads back. And in the top of the fourth, Keller leads off with a single. Now the second baseman, Brock Murtha, up to bat for the mid. First pitch called strike. Ball down, 1-1 count to the mid second baseman. Throw back over. Keller gets back to the bag. One count here in the top of the fourth. No outs. And that's lined into the gap between the third baseman and shortstop. Stallings gets that ball back in. That's the second consecutive single for the mids. That brings up the right fielder, Andrew Manning, who struck out in the second. There are no outs here in the top of the fourth, and two mids on base. First pitch to Manning, called strike on the outside of the plate. One count, two mids on, foul down the third base side. Oh, 2 count to Manning. Fouled off, back down to third base side. So after two singles for the midshipman, Manning has an 0-2 count. And that's down for a ball. Zap, the Falcon catcher, keeping that one in front of him. One, two. And hit over to Thomason, the third baseman. Only play he has is the first. And that will be one out for the mids, but the hit to the third baseman will advance the mids runners over to second and third.
Now batting first baseman, number 17, Victor Izquierdo.
For the first time, it feels like this weekend, the mids have runners in scoring position with less than two outs. And that's going to draw a pitching visit from the Falcons pitching coach. And that gives us the time to talk about Mascot Mayhem. Mascot Mayhem, one of our favorite promotions each year, returns to Alumni Hall Sunday, February 25th, as your Navy men's basketball team takes on Holy Cross at 2 p.m. watch as Bill and his mascot's friends play in a game of pickup basketball at halftime. In addition, the first 250 fans will receive a free Navy basketball jersey-shaped flag, and we will be honoring our senior class prior to the game. The Navy men's basketball versus Holy Cross game is presented by First Command. For tickets, call 1-800-US-4-NAVY or visit NavySports.com. So that quick visit for the Falcons to the mound is over. That brings up the first baseman, Victor Esquerdo. Runners on second and third for the mids with one out. First pitch he sees called strike on the outside of the plate. O-1 count. And there's a swing and a miss. 0-2 count. When is at a standstill here. And third pitch he sees is blown right by him. Esquerdo goes down swinging. Left fielder Fury now up to bat. He walked in the second inning. Two outs here. Two mids on, throw back down to third. Trying to catch Keller, but not in time. One oh count. Hit to the second baseman, Christensen. Throw over to first. There's going to be two mids stranded here in the top of the fourth. Mids still trailing 1-0 to the Falcons. Back here, bottom of the fourth, Chris Stallings, the Falcon left fielder, leading off things here in the bottom of the fourth. First pitch, swing and a miss. Shira's pitch good so far today, allowing one run and three hits. Second pitch pops straight up. Commons tried to make a play, but that's going to hit the roof. Out of play. So after two pitches, Shira's ahead in the count, 0-2. Pitching was an issue for midshipmen in the first two games as they got behind early. A lot of walks. A couple walks that scored runs for the Falcons. And today, Shira's looked comfortable on the mound. 1-2 count. And that's driven out into left center field. Fury making a play, and he makes it right on the warning track. So there's one out here in the bottom of the fourth. Right fielder Jake Grieving now up for the Falcons. In the second inning, he lined it out into left field. Here's the first pitch of the at-bat, and that's it. Out in between in the short center, and Raba on his horse comes in and makes the play. That's two outs early for the mids here in the bottom of the fourth. Chase Spencer singled in the second inning in his first at-bat, stole second, ended up at third. But was stranded there to end the second inning after Taylor hit into the double play. There are two outs here, bottom of the fourth, and that's it to Murtha. Fields it, throws it over. Mosquito, and 1-2-3, the mids in the fourth inning. We're heading to the top of the fifth, still trailing 1-0 to the Falcons. The Kids Shipment Club is the official kids club of Navy Athletics. For just $25, your membership includes exclusive gifts, free tickets to Navy sporting events, a birthday card from Bill the Goat, and more. To register, visit NavySports.com. Mac McCommons, the catcher, going to lead off for the mids here in the top of the fifth. First pitch he sees, called strike. Second pitch, going to be a little low in the strike zone for a ball. Commons has a 1-1 count. That's going to be inside. Oh, caught a piece of the plate for a called strike. Looked mighty low and inside. That one will be in the dirt. Bounces before home plate. So the mids catcher has a 2-2 count here in the top of the fifth. Swing and a miss, and Commons goes down swinging for the first out in the fifth inning.
Next up, the designated hitter, number 12, Jack Finnegan.
Jack Finnegan making his second plate appearance in this game. The DH for the midshipman. That's going to be a fouled off to the catcher. This is Finnegan's second game of the young season. Looking for his first hit of the year. And he'll have to do it behind an account 0-2 after a called strike. That's it back up the middle. Second baseman Christensen not going to get there. So in his second game of the season, seeing some action, Jack Finnegan gets his first hit of the year. Single up the middle. Now the center fielder, Zane Raba, up to bat for the Mids. Finnegan on first, one out here in the top of the fifth. First pitch he sees outside. Finnegan and first base coach looking over to the Mids dugout. Next pitch is in the dirt. Zap, the Falcon catcher, gets in front of that one. Finnegan with a nice lead over at first. That's back up the middle again, but this time second baseman makes the play, steps on first, high throw. Kulasingham, the Falcon first baseman, does catch it, but not in time to turn the double play. Eduardo Diaz, the starting shortstop for the midshipman, now up to bat. Two outs here at the top of the fifth. First pitch he sees, called strike on the outside of the plate. Raba with the lead at first. Throw back over. It was close, but first base umpire deemed it not in time. O-1 count to Diaz. Throw back over. Raba back to the bag. O-1 count, two outs. Once again, throw back over. But Raba is able to get back to the base. Raba takes off. Oh, doesn't. Looked like he wanted to. The catcher, Zap, on that pitch, it was a strike. Throws it back down to first, and Raba gets back in time. O-2 count to Diaz. Throw back over. The Falcons are keeping an eye on the midshipman center fielder. He kept inching and inching. I thought he was gone on that earlier one. Now he takes off, ball down, throw to second, not in time. And Raba has a stolen base for the Mids. So runner in scoring position for the Mids. Two outs, 1-2 count to Diaz. Hits down to the shortstop, Joe. Joe makes the play, throws it over, and out at first to Lissingham on the receiving end of that throw. And after the top of the fifth, Mid still trail the Falcons 1-0. Navy men's lacrosse tickets are on sale now. Join us at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium this spring for an exciting slate of lacrosse games, including home matchups with Penn State and Loyola. To purchase your lacrosse tickets, call or text 1-800-US-4-NAVY or visit NavySports.com. Bottom of the fifth here, first pitch from Shira's a ball. Walker Zapp, the catcher, first hitter here for the Falcons in the bottom of the fifth, and Zapp is ahead in the count, 2-0. That's line down the left field line into the Air Force bullpen. Both teams in the last two innings have sent their bullpens down, all their players down. They're full. Not really seeing any action in either one at this time, as both pitchers have been pitching very well and had a lot of command. That's called strike on a breaking ball, so 2-2 count to Zapp here in the bottom of the fifth. And that's going to be hit right back to the pitcher. Shira fields it over to Izquierdo, and there's one out here in the bottom of the fifth. Brings up the designated hitter, Christian Taylor, for the Falcons. Taylor, a pinch hitter yesterday afternoon, recorded his first hit for the Falcons. First pitch he sees here, swing and a miss. O-1 count, called strike. Shira's ahead early, 0-2. To the eight-hole hitter for the Falcons. Pitch looked good, but home plate umpire says a little high. 1-2 count. Got him looking. Shira with the strikeout of Taylor. And there are two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. Mids looking to do something for the fourth time in five innings, go 1-2-3, something they did not do a lot in the previous two games. First pitch to Christensen, the Falcons second baseman, is a ball. 1-0 count. That's going to be ball two.
Mother Earth beer is now half price. Mother Earth beer now half price.
2-0 count. Two outs in the bottom of the fifth. Down the middle, but high. So Shira is behind in the count, 3-0. To the Falcon second baseman. That catches right down the middle of the zone. 3-1 count. Two outs here in the bottom of the fifth. Swing and a miss. And after being behind 3-0, Shire Resort. The count back full. 3-2, two outs. Gets him looking. Shire's pumped. Midshipman coming off the field after another 1-2-3 inning. Heading to the top of the sixth. Still trailing one run to the Falcons. Third baseman Logan Keller, the first midshipman to come to the plate in the sixth inning. First pitch he sees is a ball. And that's going to hit Keller. Looks like the home plate umpire is issuing a warning, and now he's going to talk to the skippers for the Falcons and the Mids. While we take a break, talk about a little social media. The latest in Naval Academy athletics is as close as your computer. Thanks to NavySports.com, you can get all the information you need on all 36 varsity sports and the midshipman student athletes. Make sure to log on to NavySports.com today. Also, follow us on Facebook, X, and Instagram to be kept in the know on all things Navy athletics. So after Keller is hit by a pitch, second baseman Brock Murtha comes up to bat. Murtha singled in the fourth inning. One oh to Murtha. Foul ball. Back down the first base side. Some action down in the Falcon bullpen. That pitch, a ball. 2-1 count to Murtha. Run on first. Inside. And it said it hit him, and there's a lot of confusion going on. The Walker Zapp, the catcher, looking for an explanation. Now the head coach for the Falcons out. Couldn't quite tell if it did hit him, but the home plate umpire said it did. He's explaining it to the Falcons head coach. both pitchers have been not scared to go inside there and zap. The Falcon catcher is still not happy with that call. Whatever home plate umpire said to the Falcon skipper seemed to calm him down as he walked back to the dugout. So here in the top of the sixth, no outs. The Mids have runners on first and second after consecutive hit by pitch. And that's hit right back up to the second baseman. One runner is going to score. Throw to third. Gets Murtha at third. But Keller scores on the stand-up double by Andrew Manning. Christensen, the Falcon second baseman, kind of moved to second base for a pickoff, you know, kind of covering that base, and Manning hit it right where he was supposed to be but wasn't, and that results in the midshipman tying up this game 1-1 in the top of the sixth. The Naval Academy Athletic Association has released the Navy Sailing Collection, an exclusive line of apparel and accessories that is aimed at linking Annapolis as America's sailing capital and Navy sailing. The line features polos, fleece quarter zips, vests, jackets, hats, and a backpack. It is currently available online by visiting NavySailingCollection.com. That is, again, NavySailingCollection.com. For more information on Navy Athletics and its 36 varsity sports program, click on NavySports.com. Looks like the Falcons will have a relief pitcher coming in for Ben Weber, the starter. Weber allowed 5 hits and 1 run in his starting appearance. So we're going to take a minute and see who we've got coming in for the Falcons here in the top of the sixth. Midshipmen get a run on the board, tie this game up in the top of the sixth, 1-1. Doyle Gehring is the reliever coming in for the Falcons. Right-handed pitcher, senior from Tulsa, Oklahoma. First batter he faces will be Victor Izquierdo, the first baseman. First pitch he sees, hits it to Joe, the shortstop. Throw over to Kulisingham, and there are two outs here in the top of the sixth. Brian Fury, the left fielder, in the start tonight for Coach Rostano's midshipman in left field. up to bat. And that gets fell right under Zapp. Manning was looking to try to get third, but stayed at second. Zapp got a piece of it to knock it straight down below him. Fury walked in the second inning and grounded to second in the fourth. That pitch a strike. Fury has a 1-1 count with two outs in the top of the sixth. Swing and a miss. Got a piece of it. So 1-2 count, two outs. Manning on second. That down in the dirt, and Zapp blocks that one, keeps it in front of him. 2-2 count. Two outs. Got him. Tried to check. Could not. That's a strikeout for Fury. So the Mids do score one run to tie it. 1-1. We're heading to the bottom of the sixth. Third game of the Freedom Classic. Back to the top of the lineup for the Falcons in the bottom of the sixth. Eric Joe, the shortstop. Shira back out on the mound for the Mids. First pitch, strike. 0-1 count. And that's down in the dirt. McCommons lets that one get by, but no real threat with the runners on for the Falcons. 1-1 count. Called strike on the inside. Joe kind of looked like he wanted to get out of the way of it, but it did catch a piece of the plate. The Shire has a 1-2 count and holds 2-2 count. Air Force tonight are wearing the Doolittle Raiders uniforms that the football team and hockey team have worn this past year. And there's a hit down to third. Count Keller makes the play over and gets it. Escurto stretched out for that one. What a play by the mids third baseman. Long throw over from pretty much the almost the foul territory down the left field third base line. So there's one out here in the top or the bottom of the sixth. Sam Coolsingham, the first baseman, now up. First pitch he sees outside. One oh count. Caught a piece of the plate. 1-1. Down in the dirt. 2-1 count. To Coolsingham. Outside. 3-1 count. Here's the 3-1 pitch. Shire is going to lose him on ball four.
Next up for the Falcons, third baseman number 1,
Jay. And head coach Rostano is going to make a visit out to the mound. Looks like we're going to get a pitching change. Baseball season is back at last. Join us for our next home game on Tuesday, February 27th, as the Mids take on Maryland Eastern Shore at 3 p.m. All Navy baseball games at Max Bishop Stadium are free to attend. New pitcher for the midshipmen will be freshman number 5, Timmy Virtudis from New Rochelle, New York. Virtudis comes in relief for the mids after Matthew Shira allowed 2 hits and 1 run in a little over 6 innings of pitching. So the left-hander, Virtudis, comes in to face the left-hander, Tominson, third baseman for the Falcons. One runner on, one out here in the bottom of the sixth. First pitch outside. 4-1. Thomason popped to center field in the first inning and struck out in the third in his first two plate appearances. 1-0 count. Called strike on the outside of the plate. Caught a piece there. 1-1 count. One out. Bottom of the sixth. Fortuitous in relief. Breaking ball froze Thomason. 1-2 count. Here's the 1-2. Breaking ball hit out into right field. Manning there makes the play. Gets it into Murtha. And the first pitcher, or first batter for two to seize in relief. One out. That brings up the left fielder, Chris Stallings. So here, bottom of the sixth, Chris Stallings up to bat, breaking pitch outside, one Falcon on base. Coolisingham, who walked earlier in this inning at first, throw over, Securito secures it, right back, two for Tutis. Here's the 1-0. Inside, going to miss the plate. 2-0 count. That's going to be low. So for Tutis behind in the count, 3-0. Called strike. Three, one count, two outs in the bottom of the sixth. And going to miss outside. So Stallings draws the walk and will move Coolisingham down to second base.
Next up, right fielder, number 25, Jake Green.
That brings up the right fielder, Jake Grieving, lined to left field in the second and popped to center field in the fourth. Fortuitous in the mids trying to work out of this inning. Still tied 1-1. And first pitch that Grieving sees is fouled back into the netting. Been a beautiful day for baseball here in Kinston. The wind is standing still. Yesterday it was blowing all over the ballpark. A little chilly today. That breaking ball misses high. 1-1 count to Grieving. Fortuitous taking a look at his wristband to see what pitch they're going to call. 1-1 count. Breaking ball hit out in the right field. Manning on his horse. And that's going to get out of here for a three-run home run for the Falcons. Fortuitous left that one right over the plate, and Manning took advantage of it. Falcon fans who've made the trip over to Eastern North Carolina getting loud and excited as Jake Grieving just did clear the copy pro sign out in right field, but far enough to extend the lead 2-4-1. Chase Spencer, the center fielder, up. First two pitches he sees are balls. So Fortuitous comes in relief and with two outs gives up a three-run homer. And that's ball three. Three-oh count. And four straight pitches, four straight balls, and Spencer will take the jog down to first base, and that's going to bring out the pitching coach for Navy, try to talk and settle down the freshman reliever. The Kids Shipman Club is the official kids club of Navy Athletics. For just $25, your membership includes exclusive gifts, free tickets to Navy sporting events, a birthday card from Bill the Goat, and more. To register, visit NavySports.com. Walker Zapp, the Falcon catcher, now up to bat. One Falcon on at first. Here's the pitch. And it's a strike. Zapp was hit by a pitch in the second and grounded to the pitcher in the fifth. Swing and a miss. And Fortuitous is ahead in the count, 0-2. Two outs in the bottom of the sixth. Ball, throw down to second. Not in time. As Spencer steals second. 1-2 count, two outs. One Falcon on second, the center fielder, Chase Spencer. Swing and a miss. And that's going to be a strikeout for Fortuitous, but he does give up a three-run homer. The Mids are heading to the top of the seventh, down 4-1 here in the third game of the Freedom Classic.
Then you are a winner also. So 138 to 269.
Matt McCommons, the catcher for the Mids, leading off the top of the seventh. Check swing behind an account 0-1. A little late on that one, 0-2. The count to McCommons. All outside. Gearing the reliever for the Falcons coming in the last inning. That's inside. 2-2 count to the Mids catcher. Frozen. Strikeout to lead off to the top of the seventh. Jack Finnegan now the designated hitter up for the Mids. Got his first hit of the season in the fifth inning. The single. First pitch he sees is outside, 1-0 count. Looked to be a little outside, 2-0 count. Three straight pitches, three straight balls. Finnegan ahead in the count. 3-0 here in the top of the seventh. 4 straight pitches and 4 straight balls, and Finnegan is going to jog on down to first base.
Back up to the top of the lineup for the Eagles, center fielder number 22, Zane Rambo.
And now, center fielder Zane Raba coming up to bat for the Midshipmen as they are looking to try to rally here in the 7-8 ninth inning, get back in this ballgame down 4-1. And that first pitch is fouled off back into the netting. O-1 count to Raba. Finnegan down at first. And that's a called strike on the outside of the plate. O-2 count. Fouled off back behind the catcher. O-2 count, 1 out to Zane Raba. Outside. One, two count now. 1 out. Top of the seventh inning. Swing and a miss. Gearing gets the leadoff batter in the rotation for the Mids. There are now 2 outs in the top of the seventh. And Eduardo Diaz is now up to bat. Diaz reached on an error in the first inning and gets hit by the pitch. And will make his way down to first base.
Next up, third baseman, Logan Keller.
Logan Keller, the third baseman, now up for the Mids. Struck out in the first, singled in the fourth, walked in the sixth inning as the Mids are trying to rally with 2 outs here in the top of the seventh. Keller holds off on That pitch, 1-0 to Keller. Swing and a miss. One count. Inside. 2-1. Inside pitch fouled off, back into the netting. So Logan Keller, the third baseman, has a 2-2 count with two outs here in the top of the seventh, two runners on for the Mids. And that's going to be a ball that Zapp keeps in front of him. Full count. Here's the 3-2. Runners go. Flared out. And Critchison, the second baseman, makes the play. So the Mids strand two on the bases. And we head to the bottom of the seventh for a little stretching here at historic Grainger Stadium.
Thank you.
New pitcher for the Mids here in the bottom of the seventh, Landon Kruger, and a pinch hitter for the Falcons, number number 23, Jack Bello, replacing Christian Taylor at DH. First pitch called strike. Second pitch fouled off down the first base side. Brewer Jr. from Indiana. Named to the 2023 All-Patriot League second team as a relief pitcher. And hit out to center field and Robba camps under it. After one batter, one out here in the bottom of the seventh.
Next up for the Air Force Academy, second baseman, number 6, Connor Christensen.
Second baseman Connor Christensen now up for the Falcons. Here in the bottom of the seventh. First pitch, fastball, strike one. Second pitch, fouled off. Down the first base side. Off the concession stand as the kids scurry for that ball. 0-2 count. Upstairs, 1-2. Nats popped up into left field. Fury back on the dirt, and he will make the catch for the second out here in the bottom of the seventh inning. Eric Joe, the Falcons shortstop, now up to bat, 0-3 this afternoon. First pitch he sees, called a ball. Second pitch outside. Fouled off down the first base side. Brewer wasting no time after he gets the ball on the pitcher's mound as he's ready to go. Eric Joe the calling time. Upstairs, 3-1 count. Strike two called. So 3-2 count, two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. Mids trying to get out of this inning. And that's going to be a ball. And Joe will jog on down to first base.
Next up for the Falcons, first baseman,
Sam Coolisingham. Now up for the Falcons, and Mids are going to get a mound visit. Navy men's lacrosse tickets are on sale now. Join us at Navy Marine Corps Memorial Stadium this spring for an exciting slate of lacrosse games, including home matchups with Penn State and Loyola. To purchase your lacrosse tickets, call or text 1-800-US-4-NAVY. Or visit NavySports.com. That visit over. Cool Singham up. First pitch is a ball. One oh count. Called strike. Coolisingham, the local North Carolina guy from nearby Holly Springs, North Carolina, about an hour and a half from Kinston, fouls that one off down to third base side, out into the parking lot. 1-2 count for Kruger. Two out, bottom of the seventh. Down in the dirt, Commons looking. So that is a strikeout for the Mids, and we head to the top of the eighth, still trailing 4-1 to the Falcons. Top of the eighth inning, second baseman Brock Murtha up to bat for the Mids. Down three runs, trying to avoid the sweep in the series, the Freedom Classic. First pitch is a called strike. 0-1. Line down the left field line, but out of play. Two count here to the second baseman. High and inside. 1-2 count. Mids would like to try to get a few runs here to get back in it. That pitch is low and outside. Going to bring the count to 2-2. Murtha hits it down to third base side, and that gets by Tomlinson. And he's going to be looking for extra bases. Here's the throw to the cutoff man. And Murtha standing on second with a stand-up double. So if you're head coach Chuck Rostano, that's what you want to lead off the eighth inning here. A ball in play and a double, no outs. Murtha standing on second. Andrew Manning, the right fielder, up. Manning, the freshman, has two hits on the year. One a double, and both of them for extra bases. One a double and one a home run. 1-0 pitch is outside, 2-0. No action down in the Falcons' bullpen here in the top of the eighth. There's a called strike on the outside of the plate, 2-1. Count to Andrew Manning. Mitch trying to rally here late in the game. That pitch is down and takes off to third. Not in time. Gets past the third baseman, and Brock Murtha is going to score. Take it how we can get, however we can get it. After a wild pitch and a stolen base, score is now 4-2. We still have a 3-1 count to Andrew Manning. And that pitch looked to be outside, but home plate umpire disagreed for a strike. 3-2 count, no outs here in the top of the eighth. And that's hit back up to the shortstop, Joe. throws it over to first, and there's one out here in the top of the eighth. Murtha scored after getting on base with a double wild pitch. Throw down to third, got away, took home. Victor Esquerdo, the first baseman, now up. That fouled off. 0-1 count. Swing and a miss. 0-2 count. Esquerdo did reach base in the second inning after being hit by a pitch, one of many we've had this afternoon for both sides. Ball inside. Falcons wanted a punch out there, but 1-2 count. Esquerdo still has some life at the plate. Hits it to center field. Spencer going to be there to make the out. There are two outs. Top of the eighth as the Mids trail 4-2. Brian Fury, the left fielder, up. 1-for-3 this afternoon. First pitch he sees, called strike. Swing and a miss. Fury behind in the count, 0-2. Here in the top of the eighth. O two count. Ball low. One, two. Outside. Mids have out-hit the Falcons 6-3, but trail where it matters 4-2, and that's going to go foul down the first base side. Fury stays alive. Two-two count, two outs. Swing and a miss. Down in the dirt, going to be thrown over. Kulasing secures it, and that ends the top of the eighth inning. The Mids do score one run, but still trail 4-2 to the Falcons, heading to the bottom of the eighth.
bottom game for the Air Force Academy. Third baseman, number one, Jay Thomas.
Bottom of the eighth, new pitcher for the Mids, Nolan Jurgensen, 6'6 senior from California. First batter he faces will be the third baseman for the Falcons, Jay Tomlinson. Tomlinson 0 for 3 tonight. Popped into center field, struck out, and lined out to right field in the sixth inning. And the 1-0 count is fouled back out of play. One outside. Two-one count. That's going to be fouled back behind the catcher. Two-two count, no outs in the bottom of the eighth. Fouled back into the netting. Two-two pitch. Hit out in between the left fielder and center fielder. Raba, center fielder, will run over to make the play. He's stretching to second, and he's thrown out. Tomlinson tried to stretch that out into a double, and the mid center fielder Raba covering that got it in for the out. So there's one out here in the bottom of the eighth. Chris Stallings, the left field Falcon, up to bat, looks at strike one. Second pitch, low and outside, 1-1 count. That's hit out to third base and under the glove of Keller. Fury collects that ball, gets it in to Murtha. So with one out here, the Falcons have a runner on first. And Stalling singles into left field. Right fielder for the Falcons, Jake Grieving, now up. One out in the bottom of the eighth. One Falcon on. First pitch, called strike. Down on the outside of the plate. Hit out to center. Raba back. Makes the play. Gets it into Murtha. The wind blowing in right now, yesterday, and a little chilly. Ball not flying as far. Yesterday, that might have cleared the fence with as windy as it was blowing straight out into center. Chase Spencer, the center fielder for the Falcons, now up, two outs. First pitch he sees, ball. Stallings down at first for the Falcons. Next pitch fouled off behind the midshipman dugout. Torgerson has a 1-1 count here in the bottom of the eighth. Stallings takes off. That's fouled back into the netting. Hit and run was on there, but Spencer wasn't able to square that one up. 1-2 count, two outs. Stallings with a good lead at first. Inside, going to be called for a ball. Two-two count, two outs. Outside. Now we have a full count here. So bottom of the eighth, 3-2 count, two outs. Stallings for the Falcons on first base. Esquirdo is going to back off, and he takes off, and it's a foul. Back out of play. Skirdo holding the runner over. Stalling takes off. And that's hit to the second baseman. Murtha fields it over to Skirdo. And that's going to end the eighth inning here. Falcons held off the board. But heading to the top of the ninth, last chance for the midshipmen as they trail 4-2 in the third game of the Freedom Classic. Top of the ninth, Mac McCommons, the catcher, lead off hitter for the Mids here. First pitch is a called strike. This will be the last opportunity for the Mids. Just try to score some runs and get back in it. And McCommons is behind early, 0-2. Pitch is going to be down and inside. 1-2. Nope. The confusion here, thought it maybe he got hit by that pitch. Home plate umpire called it a ball. He's telling head coach Rostano that he didn't hear anything. So we have a 2-2 count. No outs here in the top of the ninth. And that's going to be down in the dirt. And McCommons has worded back to a full count. 3-2. No outs. Mids trailing by two. And that hits him. So on the full count, McCommons takes the jog down to first base.
designated hitter, number 12, Jack Finnegan.
Jack Finnegan, the designated hitter up now. As the mids trying to rally in the top of the ninth, down two. McCommon's on first base. First pitch to Finnegan. It's going to be outside. One oh count. That's going to be a strike. One one. Finnegan, the nine hole hitter, trying to get back to the top of the lineup, and that pitch framed, but outside. 2-1 count to the designated hitter. Swing and a miss. 2-2. Outside. So for the second consecutive batter here in the top of the ninth, we have a full count with no outs. The Commons down on first. Finnegan at the plate. Swing and a miss. And there's one out here in the top of the ninth.
Zane Robin
now up, the leadoff hitter for Midshipman. Leads the team in hits and doubles. First pitch he sees is a ball outside. So with one out, the mids trying to rally here. Down two. That pitch catches a piece of the corner. 1-1 count, one out. That pitch down in the dirt. Fielded by the catcher, Zapp. So the senior center fielder, Raba, looking to rally his team, and swings and misses. Two balls, two strikes. That's outside. So for the third consecutive batter in the top of the ninth, we have a full count. Here is the 3-2 outside, and Robidrov draws a walk. So with one out, there are two mids on base. McCommon's at second. Robba at first. And that's going to bring another visit for the Falcons out to the pitcher's mound. Eduardo Diaz, the shortstop, now up. Runners on first and second, one out here in the top of the ninth. Diaz leads the team with two home runs so far this season. First pitch he sees, called strike on the inside part of the plate. to Diaz. Hit to the shortstop. He has a tough time fielding it, but will get Raba with the force at second base. So down to the last out here, the Freedom Classic. The Mids trailing 4-2. Logan Keller, the third baseman. He does have a hit in this game. And he hits a long ball down the left field side, and that's going to draw foul into the Air Force bullpen. Hudson Leonard's the senior, is pinch running at first base for Diaz. Keller back in the box, 0-1. That pitch is down. Zapp, the Falcon catcher, keeps that in front of him. That's going to keep the Mids at first and third. So two outs. 1-1 count, runners on first and third. That pitch is down for ball two. That pitch is going to find the outside of the plate. So here we are, top of the ninth. Two balls, two strikes, two outs. Two midshipmen on as they trail by two. That looked close, but that was called a ball. Three, two outs. Top of the ninth inning. Mids trying to keep this game going. And that ball is fouled off back behind the midshipman dugout. We're going to do it again. 3-2 count, two outs, top of the ninth. And another foul ball back behind first base. Leonard's the pitch runner over on first. He's been taken off on every pitch as he's not being held at first. So here we go, 3-2 count. And that's a ball. Ball four. So Logan Keller draws a walk. Bases are loaded. Brock Murtha, the second baseman, up. Two outs. Murtha singled back in the fourth. First pitch he sees is a ball. Murtha singled in the fourth and doubled in the seventh. And he hits a ball, and it is deep. And the center fielder Spencer's underneath it. And this game is going to end on the warning track with the bases loaded. Murtha hit it as hard as he could to save the win, kept it in. And for the first time in this series between Air Force and Navy, Air Force is going to sweep Navy with a 4-2 win here in the third game of the Freedom Classic. Thank you to everybody who helped out with this, our engineer, our camera people. We enjoyed it, and I hope you did too. We are done here with the Freedom Classic. Air Force Academy wins 4-2 and wins the series 3-0. Thank you, and have a great afternoon. The Freedom Classic, Day 10 is 2069.